Welcome back to Talk War Gaming, and in this video it's going to be a little bit different. We're going to kind of combine a product review and a tutorial at the same time. I will be painting one of the Zombicide miniatures using both of these Army Painter paint sets. We've got the Zombie Core paint set, which contains 10 paints and a paintbrush, and the Zombicide Toxic Prison paint set, which contains 6 paints as well, specifically for the Prison Outbreak miniatures and the Toxic City Mall sets as well. So I've got the model all primed and ready here. I've used skeleton bone as an undercoat for this, so I've obviously cut the mold lines away, washed it and did the undercoat. So let's get started with the tutorial. So the miniature that I'll be painting as part of this tutorial is the Berserker Fatty from the Prison Outbreak set of Zombicide. And the first colour I'm going to be using is the prison jumpsuit, which is like a quite a nice bright orange, and that'll be using the that'll be painted onto his jumpsuit. So let's get started with that. So the prison jumpsuit layer is now completed. The coverage is quite nice, which is quite indicative of the Army Painter range. The pigment level's quite high, so bright colours cover really well. The next paint that I'll be using is Scaly Hide, which is also from the Toxic Prison paint set for the Army Painter, and this will be used to get the scales on the face and the body, and then also on the arm as well. So as you can see, the scaly hide coat is done. At this stage, I'm not really worrying too much about definition. Those will come later on when I do some washes. But the next step is going to be dead black. Now this is just from the standard Zombicide paint set. That will be used on the boots and then also the zipper on the side as well. So now that I've finished painting the black areas, I'll be moving on to the hair and the moustache. For that I'll be using Brain Matter Beige, which is from the standard Zombicide paint set. So now that the hair and the moustache are completed, the next stage is to add some definition. So I'll be using the jumpsuit shader from the Toxic and Prison paint sets to just go over the jumpsuit areas. I've got another shader for the other areas, so for this stage, just to cover the orange sections. So now that the jumpsuit has got a bit more definition, we're going to continue the washes, but instead we're going to be using the zombie shader from the core set, and that we're going to go over all of the areas that we haven't covered with the jumpsuit shader, and probably just go over the hair as well, but maybe just water it down a bit so it's not as strong. So now that the shade has been applied to the whole of the model, the next step is to go back over with the scaly hide, prison jumpsuit, and probably also the brain matter beige as well. This is just to get some kind of enhanced definition. So obviously we'll be going over with the over the scales, the jumpsuit, and the hair with those. You can also use one of the other paints, which is zombie skin from the core paint set, and you can just use this to highlight some of the facial features as well if you want. So at this stage, the only thing that hasn't been highlighted yet is the black parts, namely the boots and the zipper. To highlight those, I'm going to use Filthy Suit, which is from the core set. And I'll just be doing quite a watered down highlight on those, so it's not too stark. It'll just be on the tips of the boots and then maybe a few of the upper areas of the zip there. So at this stage, now that everything's been highlighted at least once and we've got the shades in there as well, you can pretty much just leave the model as it is. That's if you like your zombies pretty clean though. So I think the next stage that I'll be taking is Crusted Gore, which is a Crusted Sore, sorry, which is from the core paint set. And this will just be applied around the kind of areas where you'd expect the blood to build up around a zombie, the hands, and then around the mouth as well. Probably just do inside the mouth there as well. So now that the first layer of the gore is completed, the next step is to add glistening blood, which is it's kind of like a similar to Bloodletter if you're familiar with the Citadel paints. It dries like a shiny colour, so it looks a lot more like fresh gore. So those will just be applied over the top of where I've I put the crusted sore paint, and probably not as much though, just so I can still see parts of the crusted sore below. So here is the completed miniature, and I'm quite impressed as to how it's turned out, really. I mean, all of the paints used to paint this were from the Army Painters zombie paint sets, both the core and the prison and toxic maw set as well. The selection of paints is great. I mean, they've tailored them specifically for this range, so the scaly hide is perfect for the kind of paints that you want. You don't have to worry about mixing anything. The paints that they come as they come, you can just apply straight on there, and you can get all of the depth you need just by using the shaders that come with it as well. So if you do own a zombie side and you are thinking of painting up the zombies that you get in there, I would definitely recommend picking up at least this set if you just got the standard edition. But if you do have the Prison Outbreak or Toxic City Mall, I would get this one as well. If you get these, it's going to make life so much easier painting the models. You don't have to worry about mixing. All the colours that you need are here. The shaders just save so much time. You don't have to go, especially if you want to get a good job. And because there's so many models in those box sets, anything which helps you speed up the process is going to be fantastic. Well, that was our first video painting tutorial. If you did enjoy it and you found it useful, let us know in the comments and we'll probably do some more. Don't forget to visit our website as well, where we have tutorials, editorials, news and reviews all on there as well, at talkwargaming.com. And if you would like to stay up to date with any of the videos that we'll be doing in the future, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching and goodbye.